great, wide, vast, so large, beautiful. Mother Nature is beautiful. It is everywhere. Wonderful, attracting world. With the wonderful water around you, curled. And the wonderful grass on your breast, whirled. You are beautifully dressed, right? Aha. You are so great. And I'm so small. You are means it's whirled. It's so great. And I'm so small. I'm as a human being, I'm as one person, or even all people on earth are so small regarding that vast, beautiful world, big world. I tremble to think of you. When I tremble, this means when I think carefully about you, I got amazed. Wow, how wonderful, how big, how great you are, my world, at all. And yet, when I said my prayers today, every day we have our prayers. For us as Muslims, we have 5 prayers a day. They say their prayers maybe 2 times, 3 times, whatever. They are Christians, as you know, but we will take it as Muslims. Every day when we pray, when we perform our prayers, when we say our prayers, a whisper inside me, it seemed to say, whisper, as if I hear a sound inside me to say, you are more than earth. You consider yourself a little small? No, you are more than the whole earth. Though you are such a dot, though you are little in size, but in value, you are more and more than the earth, the whole earth. You are much more bigger than the earth because we have minds. You can love and think, yes, why are we as humans bigger than the whole earth? We have feelings, we have hearts, we can love, and we have the brain, we have a mind, we are the best, we are supreme. So the earth with all its components cannot think, but you can. So Allah Azza wa Jal made us, or has created us, supreme to the earth and all its components, whether plants, whether animals, whether anything on earth, man. And I mean by man, human, I mean people, I mean mankind, much more supreme, superior to all the components of earth, anything on earth, because we have minds to think and we have hearts to feel and to love. So here we can say the poet is saying, we say, thanks God, you give us such beautiful world, such wide, wonderful, great world. Mother Nature and all its elements, grass, water, sky, air, mountains, every scene around is beautiful. And with all such wonder, with all such greatness of the world, how vast, how big, how amazing, how wonderful. Stop and see yourself. You man, you human, you are a dot in such a world by size, but by value, no, you are much more greater, greater than the earth and everything on earth. Why? Because Allah Azza wa Jalla has given you what makes you supreme, what makes you wonderful, more wonderful, more amazing, more interesting, more and more controller of the whole earth, that you have mind to think and you have heart to love, to feel. So feel every day the beauty of the whole world of the earth, and say in your prayers, when you pray, when you say your prayers, say, thanks Allah, you give me all such wonderful, the whole such wonderful world, together with such gifts, great gifts inside me. I can talk, I can think, I can feel, I can love, I can be aware, I can say yes, I can say no, I can take a decision. So I'm superior man. And I mean by man, mankind, humans are superior to all of Allah Azza wa Jalla creatures. You understand the idea? You understand me?
Alhamdulillah, mercy,
understand. Yes, this is really very interesting. And I believe 100% in these words.
You miss or yeah. Miss Halad
Ibrahim skin بتاعتها. Word it? Colored. يبقى هنا ايه؟ ايه؟ مش كده؟ ايه؟ ولد كان طيب breast بي بي مظبوط؟ small yes. all small سي سي كل اتنين مع بعض day say دي دي day say dot not ها؟ اي يبقى هنا الشاعر ماشي ايه؟ دي بنسميها ايه؟ بنسميها يا اولاد couple rhyme يعني كل two lines مع بعض each two lines make a rhyme wallet curled breast dressed small all they say dot not huh you got you remember
yes we got
remember the rhyme scheme come to the alliteration come to the similarity come to the simile to the metaphor let's have a line by line great white beautiful, wonderful, world, wide, wonderful, world. What is here? Wide, wonderful, world. The same sound, the same consonant. What is this? This is called what? The repetition of the same consonant sound at the beginning of words within the same line. Wide. Wow, wonderful. Wow, world. This is alliteration. This is called alliteration. Alliteration here give special music, easiness when we read, when we understand the words. Okay? This is internal music. Okay?
Okay. Right?
With wonderful water. Around you colored with wah wonderful wah water wah so we have wah again this is what this is what
alliteration
again alliteration yes around you colored look at colored we can say this is the word colored the word can curl can go around can lean Can you set and you have something curled around you? This is the world. What is here? When I say the world curled, what is here? Do we have a simile or we have a metaphor here? We have a simile or a metaphor here? Huh?
Metaphor?
We have a metaphor because the poet here likens the world with someone or with something that gets around us. Like a protection, like something beautiful to look at, like we can say for amusement, for protection, I said, like that. So as if the world were something going around us. And we are in the center. We are in the center, why? What is in the center? The most important. It goes curled around us. And we are in the center of the world, in the eye of the world, because we as humans, the most important component in this world. Right? And the wonderful grass on your breast world. What do you mean by breast world? Who has breasts? People or the world? Who has breasts? You know the meaning of breast? Who has? Huh. This is the surface, the upper surface of the world. This is the ground. It is covered with grass. But here, again, there is another metaphor because the poet likened the surface of the world or the ground with someone. The uppermost part, it's the uppermost part is covered with grass. So it's green. It's green means this is very pleasant to your eyes and to your psyche also. I mean, you feel relief. You feel good when you look at it. The green color is very relieving to us. Do you agree with me? Do you agree? So when we say breast world, this is another metaphor because who has breast, an animal or someone? So he likens the world with someone or with an animal who has a breast. You are beautifully dressed. You are beautifully dressed. We can say the world get dressed. The world get dressed. Can the world dressed? Can we dress the world with clothes? For example, who get dressed? People or the world? People or the world get dressed? People get dressed. It's us.
People.
Get dressed, well dressed. You are so great and I'm so small. Great and small. What is here? Here is a similarity or here is a difference? Great and small. This is a contrast or a similarity? Great and small. Great, very big. Small, maybe tiny. Huh? Similarity here or a difference between small and great? Similarity or a difference? Yes. Here is a similarity or a difference. Can you hear me? There is a difference here. There is a contrast. The word great is an antonym, an opposite. They have opposite meaning. One is very great and one is very small. So great, so big, so small, tiny. So we have a contrast here. We have different meanings. We have opposites here. This is also for the rhythm of the poem. Okay. Who is you?
Okay.
Who is you? You are so great. Who is you? The poet is talking to who? Huh? Who is you? He said, you are so great. Who is you? He's talking to? The poet here is talking to or about man, about people in general. You're tiny, small in size, but you're so great. You have to understand that. You have to understand that you are so great by value in the whole universe, in the whole world. I tremble to think of you. When I think of you, when I think about you, and what God, what Allah Azza wa Jal has given you or gifted upon you, I got trembled. Oh, how great, how wonderful, how big characteristics you have, how big merits you have. Walid at all. So we have, and yet, when I said my prayers today, no alliteration here. A whisper inside me seemed to say. Can a whisper say? A whisper inside me. Huh? He has an idea. He has a concept inside him. He has a belief inside him that the man is much more greater than the world. Can ideas and the concepts talk to us? We have some ideas inside. We have some concepts. We have some beliefs inside that we are much more bigger than the whole universe. But can ideas, concepts, beliefs talk to us? Can they talk to us? Mm-hmm. Can they talk to us, please? Mm-hmm. Ask me, can they talk? You have an idea around in your mind, okay? And as if you were, you're listening to someone talking from inside. Can ideas talk? Can we hear our ideas, our concepts, our beliefs talking to us from inside? Can we? Can we?
Yes.
We can feel, but we can't hear.
Because we can't hear.
Yes. So this is again another in whisper here. This is again, there is a metaphor because the poet likens the our concepts or ideas or even beliefs inside to someone talking to us, and we can hear a clear voice. It's a whisper, a low voice, but we can hear clear to us. So ideas do not talk. Concepts do not talk, and also beliefs do not talk, but we can feel, we can believe in greatly. That's why we can hear them greatly. So in whisper here, we have another metaphor because we have ideas inside. We have concepts we don't have. We don't have someone talking to us from inside. Rather, we have some ideas, but because we believe in greatly, because we know for sure that we are much more greater than the whole world. So it is as if someone is talking from inside to me and I can hear well, even if it is a whisper, even if it is in a low voice. So you get my idea here? You get my idea? Okay, you are more than the earth, though you are such dot. You and you, you and you, the same word, you, then another time you, you, you. This is the repetition of the same word. This is the repetition of the same word within the same line. We call this consonancy. This is like alliteration, but we repeat the whole word. That is you as a whole and you again as a whole, repeating the same word in the same line. This is called a consonance. This is called a consonance. Alliteration, the repetition of the first consonant sound within many words in the same line. But consonants, the same word is repeated. So have you and you again. This is called the consonants. You and you again. Okay? Okay? You understand? The repetition of the same word within the same line. You are more than earth. Though you're such a dot, you at the very beginning and you again before the end. This is consonance. This repetition is called the consonance. You understand, my dear? You understand?
Yes.
You can love and think, and the earth cannot. Can and cannot. Huh? We have what? We have contrast or similarity here. Can, cannot. Contrast or similarity? Can and cannot. Yes.
Contrast.
Yeah, this is a contrast. These are different meanings. And we have exclamation. We have an exclamation mark here at the very end. Why? Can you guess? Can you guess why the poet gave exclamation here? Why? What does the poet exclaim about here? What did the poet exclaim about here? Why there is an exclamation here? To say what? The poet, yes, Aram, say.
It describes the word, but it describes the meaning of word.
Okay, to give again and to assure his idea that although we as humans, as a human being, as people, although we are tiny, we are small, just a dot on that very vast, wonderful, beautiful, great world, this earth, this very big Mother Earth, we are greater. Although we are a dot, we are greater. Just dots in the universe, but we are greater. Greater by what? By our characteristics. What are the most two attractive characteristics by the poet, or the poet think they are them, they make us greater. What are these characteristics? The brain and the heart. We can think and we can love. We can feel. So we have these two make us supreme and superior to all of Allah's Wajal creatures. So we have these two characteristics to make us remarkable in the universe, although we are little by size, although we are very small by size. But by value, no. By characteristics, no. By merits, no. We are much, 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 much more supreme and superior. And who gifted us? Allah Azza wa Jalla.
Yep.
Who gifted us? Allah
Azza wa Jalla.
So we have to say, thanks Allah every time, every now and then we have to say, thanks Allah, you gifted us the gifts, the blessings of thinking, of brain and heart. Okay, my dear?
Yeah.
Yeah. Very, very nice. So nice. I feel it very nice, wallahi.
So nice. It's so much culture.